you to drop in, and just in time for a song.
Journeying down through the gates, watch the night suffocate all the light as it smothers the sun. I can tell by the moon you'll be joining me soon as a guest in my fortress of fun. And I can't wait to see you and once again free you, release from your humorous hair. Someday I...
What is up, all you comic book fans? This is a comic book villain coming to you with another comic book haul. Happy Comic Book Wednesday to everybody for February 15th, 2017. I hope everybody makes it out to their local LCSs and gets what they want, finds what they're looking for. I went to two LCSs today because my LCS, well, this is what I thought. This is one bag. This is the other bag from my, that one's pretty thick, from my LCS where I have my subscription. And this is a third bag. Same place for my where I got my subscription. It is just a, it's a toy. However you want to call it. And put that down. Now, the reason I went to the first LCS is because my LCS, I didn't think he was going to have this cover. Because he orders some books, but he won't order all the covers because he is a smaller shop. And of course, if you if he orders it, it's on a shelf. That's money there, you know. That's just sitting on a shelf. So I understand that for him, you know. So I went to the other LCS in the morning because it's bigger and they order all. I know they always have all kinds of covers that I'm gonna want if I need to go over there, which I did. Like I said, I went ahead and went over there first before I went to the second one because that's where I have my box where I know I'm gonna get my and then anything else that I where I'm gonna have my. Pre-ordered books in my box already, and then plus anything else that I want in off the back wall, which you call the back wall because that's where he puts the new comics that come in. Alrighty, well, let's go ahead and get started. The Wildstorm number one came out today. This is the C cover. This is the reason I went to the other location because I didn't think he was going to have this cover, and this is the one that I wanted. I like this one out of the all three of them the best. This so that's why I went over there. Oh, that looks interesting. It's in there so far. I can't wait to get into that one. And if y'all seen one of my last two videos, y'all know that I've been saying about Image and their 25th anniversary, and they're doing commemorative covers. This one right here is God Country number 2. This has the Savage Dragon number 1 from back in like 1993, 4, maybe 5. So I'm picking. I don't pick this comic book up, so I don't know what anything nice artwork in here. But I mean, I don't know anything about this book. Like I said, I do not get this book, so I couldn't tell you. I just picked it up strictly for the cover because I want all the variant covers that Image is putting out. Now this one is Invincible 133. This one has the commemorative. Youngblood's number 1 cover on this one. This is Invincible 133. This is also another comic that I do not pick up. So, like I said, this is pretty much... I can read it, but it'll probably be Chinese to me. But, like I said... Now, this one I do know because I get this book. This is an awesome storyline right now. This is Kill or Be Killed number 6. This has the Walking Dead number 1 cover on this one. That is the cover to Walking Dead number 1. Now the Kill or Be Killed, this storyline is awesome. I mean, this is if y'all not following this, it's only into 6 issues. Y'all should pick it up and try to see where this is going. This is pretty cool. The next one right here is another one that I don't get, that I also don't pick up, so I couldn't tell you about it much. This is Manifest Destiny. This one also has I thought this cover looked sick. Look at that. Zombies everywhere. He's got a zombie in his knife and he's sitting there. I'm not too sure. I got to look up. Anybody knows what cover swap this one is? Let me know because I want to find out. I can look it up, but I just want to check it out. This book does look pretty good. It looks interesting. Ooh, I don't know if it all takes Manifest. It looks like it takes back like in the settler days. Look, they have log cabin homes and he's riding a horse. This look like the old cabins from the Jesse James era. This is a book that, oh man, it's in 26. That's issue 26. So that's kind of far into it already. And this is this is Walking Dead 164. This is the cover swap of Wildcats number one. I remember that. All these covers, except for this one. I don't remember this one. But this one, except for The Walking Dead. I don't have The Walking Dead number one. But the Invincible one I got. And the Savage Dragon I got. And then this one, I do have this one as well. The Wildcats. This one is The Walking Dead 164. Look at that. The guy, what's his name, with his eyeball missing. I guess the girl that he's trying to dig down. And there's Rick looking all tough, but oh no, is that Rick? Yeah, I guess so. Should be. I mean, but like, his freaking arm's cut off, and he's got a semi-automatic. He always carries a revolver. But anyway, that's the cover to Wildcast number one. And like I said, I picked up these there because I knew I was gonna get. I wanted to get doubles of these anyway, and I didn't want to go in just for this cover. So I ended up buying. I said, you know what? I'll buy these one single ones there, and when I go back to my shop, to where my box is, I'll just pick up ones because I was planning on picking up two of each of those covers anyway. True Believers, Wolverine X-23, number one. This one right here, this True. I can't wait till this movie comes out. This movie looks pretty good. That Logan. That looks pretty good right there. So I picked up that one and as well, True Believers Wolverine number one. Hey, I think I already had this one. Enemy of the State number one. I think I do have this one already. I've got to double check. I thought I had that. Let me see. Sorry about that, guys. I just want to make sure. And Save the Tiger, Origin, that one. Maybe not. I thought I did have, but maybe not. I guess I didn't. Well, anyway, like I said, that's from that LCS that I went to, so I can make sure I get. And that's the thing, though, is that when I went, and that's the other thing, when I went to my LCS, he actually had that cover. And I was like, man, I wasted time going to that one. This one is for my LCS, but this is my figure. I ended up picking up this, the Spawn figure. The new one that just came out, I guess it's Rebirth right here. It looks pretty cool. Got it for a good price because all the other LCSs had them. I hate when he puts the stickers on this thing because now I got to try to get it off. Paid $20 for it everywhere else. You know, they have it for $24.99, $26.99. So I got it for $20 plus, of course, plus taxes. But I hate, like I said, I hate when he puts the tag right there. I got to see if I can get it off without really messing up the box. So put that back there for right now. And let's get on to my comics from my LCS. Look at all those comics. And like I made a comment in my last video, I believe, that it was going to be another over $100, and it sure was. Again, let me just get all these straight for y'all guys. I'm sorry about this. Alrighty, this is all my box. This is all from the back wall, and I can't believe I forgot to pick up this one last week. Jessica Jones number 5, I forgot to pick it up, so I got it now. Couldn't believe it, so now I got it. So anyway, but He-Man number 5 came out. This cover looks awesome. Look at that Castle Grayskull right there. Look at that. This cover, this artwork looks awesome. Storyline is good. Look at that. The artwork inside here is just awesome. This is just an all-around very, very good book. He-Man, Thundercats. Gwenpool number 12 came out. Looks like she's about to get thrown in the fire off a conveyor belt. This one, like I said, this is a cool read too. This is looks like Shaun White up there. Doesn't it look like Shaun White right there? If anybody knows the snowboarder Shaun White. Venom number 4 came out. Digging this cover. Really digging this cover. Nobody had the what's his name's cover, the Jock or Joke or whatever. I forgot his name. But anyway, nobody had his cover. And even if they did, they're charging like $6 or $7, $8 for it when Midtown Comics has it for a regular $3.99, same price. I hate when other when LCSs do that. But anyway, the Clone Conspiracy, Dead No More, number 5. This is the Del Otto cover. Really digging his covers. Really liking his covers. This has been a very good storyline as well. Look at the artwork inside here. Awesome. Look at Dr. Octopus right there. This is real nice. And remember, like I said, I was going to pick up 2 copies of those other ones anyway. So here's one of them that I got from this LCS. This is the one. This is, of course, the Kill or Be Kill. This is the one for The Walking Dead, number 1. Superman, number 17, came out. I only picked up the A cover this week on this one. I wasn't feeling the B cover. So, like I said, and plus, I am trying to cut back on... trying to cut back on my double copies as well, as far as getting 1 A covers and B covers. Super Sons number 1 came out. This is the B cover. I actually picked up both covers of this one. Since this is their first one, I went ahead and picked up both covers. This one looks pretty cool. Can't wait to see how this one is. And here's the A cover right here. This is Super Sons. This is the A cover right here. Looking good, looking good. Green Lanterns number 17 came out today. Look at that. This cover just looks awesome as well. Look at that. That cover looks awesome. Rebirth Batwoman number 1 came out. I was going to get both covers, but I didn't like really feeling the other one, so I stayed strong and I only picked up this one cover on it. This is the A cover of Batwoman. Batman number 17 came out today. I only picked up one cover as well. I usually pick up both covers on the Batman and the Detective Comics because they're usually looking, both of them, looking pretty good. But I wasn't feeling the second one, so it was easy for me to leave it on the shelf because I am trying to cut down. Harley Quinn number 14. This is the B cover. I only picked up this one right here as well. I've been picking up Harley Quinn. I've been picking up both covers as well on the Harley Quinn, but wasn't feeling the A cover this week. So, like I said, cutting out and making it easier and easier for me just to leave them behind. Because Harley Quinn, I was picking it up whether I liked it or not. One of the covers, I was getting both of them. Raven, Carnival Souls right here. Look at this, number 6. Raven. This is another good read right here. Raven, if anybody's been following Raven, anybody gets this one. This is another good book right here. Raven number 6. Nice looking cover. And this is out of my subscription box. Apocalypse 5. Trying to remember if this came out or this was something that he owed me from a damage. I think this is what he owed me from a damage comic. Because I think I got part... Oh, no, this is part 5 of 5. This is the last one. No, this is the last one. My bad. I'm sorry, guys. This is the last one. I guess it did come out today. It did come out today. Because this one right here, Apocalypse... Because I haven't read these. I knew this was a 5-part series, so I was going to wait till I got them all in. Out of my box as well, the regular Walking Dead cover, number 164. So this is just a regular cover right here that he pulls for me because I have a subscription. And this is the La Muerta. This is a one-shot. Look at the beautiful cover on this. This is a one-shot. This is called the number 1 pinups. I guess it's just going to be basically, oh my goodness. It's going to be just regular pictures of her, the people. Let's see. I thought they were going to be different artists, but it looks like they're all the same, it looks like. Let me see. Oh, look at that cover right there. Oh, my God. That is a beautiful picture. R. Ortiz did this one. Can't see. That's a different one right there. Look, that whoever's name that is, it's in handwriting, but really can't tell. This one's R. Ortiz right there. R. Ortiz. Oh my God, look at that one. That one's like she's in a Mexican bandito outfit. Hey, sorry, my little doggy's getting in the trash. This is a cover to the La Muerta number one. And then look at this. This one's from R. Ortiz as well. Very colorful. Very beautiful artwork. Look at this. This can't tell who that's from. You can just see right there is the name. But that is nice. Looks like those are some H&Ks. Those are some H&K guns to me. This is R. Ortiz again. Nice work. R. Ortiz. Oh, somebody's in a bathing suit. This is by another guy as well. I gotta see who these artists are. Look at this one. That one looks awesome. This is just a beautiful book. Oh, look. This one is in one of the skeleton spandex. She's still in the skeleton spandex. They had four different covers, but they went up in price range. Look at this one. That one's nice. Look at this. They went up in price range. This one was the A cover. Beautiful covers. This one was the A cover, and it was cover price. I think this is the cover of number two, I think. And there's Coffin Get It Now exclusive. Let me see. They did they had a cosplay cover. They had this one. This one was $3.99. Then one of the other issues was $3.99. And there was an issue, I think, for $5.99. Then there was two more. One of them was like $20. And the other one was like $40. All right. Well, I just kept showing you the pictures in there. Spirit Hunters number 6 came out today. This is Little Sister. And this right here is the C cover. Right here, I only ordered the C cover. They come out with three covers as well, and this is the cover that I like the best. This has been a very good story too. I've been reading it. It's pretty cool. It's taking place inside like a kind of like a mental institution, mental ward or whatever. It's pretty good. I like it. But the artwork is really nice in here as well. They've been doing some good work on this from this Zenscope. And Kong of Skull Island number 8 came out from Boom. This one right here is Kong of Skull Island. Can't wait for the movie to hit, too. I think the movie hit next month, I think. We got some nice artwork in here. See if the movie's anything like the comic. But this is very nice. Kong of Skull Island. And, of course, then this is the regular Kill or Be Kill cover right there. So what I do need, and if you noticed, out of these, I only had, I wasn't going to get the Savage Dragon double. I wasn't going to get the Invincible. I have that double right there. But not that one. This is the other one that I wanted, the double one. And he was sold out by the time I got there, which I would have had all of them. Because I'm usually the first one there at his shop. I would have had all of them if I didn't go to the other shop to get that one book. But I didn't. You know, so that was bad on me. That was all my fault. So let me see. Cover pick of the week. Man, there's actually two of them that I like. I really like this one. Gonna have to go with La Muerta, the one shot. And where is it at? Nope, not that one right there. Where is it at? Is it this one? Nope. This one right here. That cover looks sick too. Those are my two cover picks of the week right there, guys. And like I said, that's all I have. I don't think I have anything on order. I know I don't have anything on order. So as far as comics, yeah, I don't have anything. So, yeah, and I got to see if I can get that sticker off without messing up the box. But anyway, guys, that is my haul for this week. Like I said, hopefully everybody gets out to local LCSs, gets what they want, finds what they're looking for. And like I said, on that one cover swap, don't forget, if anybody knows, let me know what cover swap that was from Manifest Destiny. Alrighty, guys, that's it, and I'll see you next Wednesday. The Comic Book Villain out. Laters.